Combination of a different IOLs or a blended vision setup, including monovision. Is it a good idea? When does it make sense? What are no-go areas? And what should you consider if you are playing a blended vision or a monovision approach in your particular case? Hi there! My name is Alexey and you are at IOL-adviser channel, telling the truth about IOLs. First of all, I would like to apologize for not being live on YouTube for such amount of time. I know that many of you are waiting for my new videos. And I want to reassure you that it is in my plans to come back to YouTube and make more videos to explain you more about different intraocular lenses options, vision expectations, and so on. Nowadays, I'm working hard on my new project with artificial intelligence assistant, helping you to understand your vision better, helping you to understand better what your doctor is saying to you, how to compare different lenses, and what is the best lens options for your particular case, which will help you to be prepared for a final discussion with your doctor. The project is way more complicated than I've expected at the beginning, and we're working hard with my partner from the United States. Sergey, all the best to you. Details are in the description below. Well, let's come back to the topic of that video. First of all, let's discuss, is it a good idea or no, having a blended vision approach or monovision. Let's separate the two points, blended vision versus monovision. The monovision setup is when you are using the same IOL models with a different refractive target, when the different eyes are targeted at different total refraction of your eye, at plano or at minus something. It is not the topic of today's video, however, I will touch it a little bit further, explaining some different aspects. Nowadays, I'm talking about the different IOLs and two different eyes of the same patient. And is it a good idea or not, depending on the situation and depending on what exactly you want to achieve. Generally, I can tell you that it might be a good idea, but only in a case if you exactly know what's wrong today with your particular setup with the first IOL implanted, and then if you have something wrong and you want to improve some outcomes with a second option, with a second other IOL. So, whether blended vision may have sense? In majority of cases, blended vision may have sense in two cases. Either it's planned before the surgery or it's a kind of need after the surgery. And it makes sense only in a case if you exactly know what you're planning to achieve. Why do you need this blended vision? And what exactly missing in, let's say, one IOL, which you want to achieve with a second IOL. As you probably heard already from my previous few videos or from your surgeon or from internet, there is no any single ideal IOL in the world. So that's why any IOL is associated with a different compromises, with a different benefits and different disadvantages, which you either have to accept as, let's say, payment for your benefits, which you like to get. And just in the cases, if you want to achieve more and you are ready to accept that your eyes will see a little bit differently if you compare it that way, you may go with a blended vision or monovision. But it's only in a case if you really understand what exactly you need. As I mentioned already, there are two approaches. The first one is a blended vision approach, which is planned before the surgery. For instance, it might be a combination of EDOF lens and the trifocal lens for whatever reason. It might be a combination of different lenses due to some pre-existing clinical conditions. For instance, if a patient is willing to have a big level of spectacle freedom, however, one eye has some limitations to be able to use a trifocal or EDOF lens, for example. Or if a patient's willing to have some advantages of one lens and advantage of another lens, and you expect that the disadvantages of both lenses will be compensated somehow by that blended approach. It's also a possible way. And maybe that's all. So pre-existing clinical and pre-existing, let's say, willingness to have certain specific setup of your vision. So it makes sense if you exactly understand what you want to achieve and you and your doctor understand what limitations and what options your lenses give you in terms of combination of different technologies. And the second group of reasons when it makes sense to have a blended vision, it's when you are not happy with your visual outcomes with a first IOL implanted and you or your doctor will suggest you a different IOL for second eye to compensate something which you are missing in that particular IOL which you have now with your first eye. For instance, you are not happy with near vision with your particular IOL right now. It doesn't matter. It's due to the wrong IOL selected or your wrong expectations or, let's say, kind of miscalculation of refractive power. You may have, let's say, not satisfactory near vision or not satisfactory far vision. And not often, but it may happen that your intermediate vision might be not as good as you need or you have expected. For that particular case, the second IOL may compensate this, and it's absolutely fine to try to combine different lenses to have a better outcomes in that particular case. What are no-go areas with blended vision setup? What you should know, what you should consider, and what you should be aware of? Maybe many of you have read or heard that a combination of monofocal and multifocal lenses is a bad combination. I can agree to such an extent, but from another side, we have a number of cases with a successful implantation of blended vision of monofocal plus multifocal or trifocal IOL. The problem here is that some patients are not able to neuroadapt to different eyes with the different IOLs of that particular type, like monofocal or enhanced monofocal and the multifocal lenses. Some patients are reporting a bad visual outcomes with the first multifocal lens, and then by experience we know that if patient is brave enough and surgeon is insistive enough to put the second multifocal lens to the second eye, such a magic happens and patient starts to be absolutely happy with two multifocal or trifocal lenses. From another hand, we have plenty of publications and experience that a monofocal plus multifocal lens give good advantages. For instance, if a patient had a first monofocal lens and then is not happy with lack of near vision, the second multifocal or trifocal or bifocal or trifocal IOL will give to the patient a good reading and good intermediate vision for whatever reason. And well, it works. The better scenario if a patient has a multifocal lens and for whatever reason patient is not happy with maybe halos and glare, and patient want to reduce the appearance of halos and glare or to improve night vision or improve quality of far vision, it might work for the patient that monofocal or better enhanced monofocal or even EDOF lens with non-diffractive technology will work better for that particular setup. So no-go area in this case is negotiable, and you should be ready to discuss with your doctor what risks are associated. Are you ready to take that risk? What will happen if you will not be happy with the setup or you will not neither adapt and so on? So it's a first case of no-go area, or I would say not no-go, but something to discuss and carefully consider. The second, and I would say the most important no-go area, is the case if you're happy with your first IOL implanted. For whatever reason, if you're happy with your vision with the first eye, and it's all fine, and you just starting to think, well, maybe it's something better exists, which will even enhance my vision, but you are still happy with what you have, I strongly recommend not go to this area, because you never know how you will react to the another lens, because you may have some fantasies, some expectations that another lens will enhance something, improve something. But if you're already happy with that, what you have, the best way is to go with the same lens. Of course, if you're ready to take the risk, like I explained before, you can go. If your surgeon will agree and you really understand what is it about for you, you can try. But I suggest if you're happy with the first lens, go with the same lens of that same time with the same refractive target. And you will be, in vast majority of cases, absolutely happy. And maybe the last option of no-go area, especially for monovision and maybe for blended vision as well, if the patient has a high quality demand for either far vision binocularly or near vision or whatever. In that case scenario, any type of blended vision might slightly compromise either far or near vision or something like that. So if you have by your profession, by your hobby or just willingness to have some specific ideal vision at certain distance or a certain lighting conditions like dim light, night, whatever, it's better to avoid the combination, because if you know that certain type of lens will suit you the best, and you really need the best type of vision at that particular setup, it's better to go with certain optical type and then to add or to compensate drawbacks by glasses or contact lenses if you will need something else. So again, it's absolutely subjective, and it's important for you to think, to reflect what you really need. You have to understand what different lenses will give you. You have to try to avoid listening and to believing to all the marketing materials, because in the marketing, any manufacturer with every lens is always trying to give you a perception that the lens is the best in class, the best in the world, etc. But you have to understand that you have benefits and you have some disadvantages for you. So the best way is to think, to reflect, and to have a deep and open discussion with the surgeon about your visual needs, about your visual expectation, about your fears, concerns, and so on. And if you're a surgeon, I also encourage you to have a deep, open discussion with your patient to really uncover the drawbacks, your concerns as well, your experience, and, well, try to find the best combination for that particular case. Well, I know that that type of long and deep discussion with the surgeons are not always possible, and that's why you can try to use my IOL Advisor Assistant, AI Assistant, on my website, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video. Or as another option, you can schedule with me a personalized IOL consultation where I can discuss different options and I can guide you through the different technologies, IOLs, and help you to be prepared for a deep discussion with your surgeon of your particular case. Please keep in mind that I'm not a doctor, and it will be just a technical consultation about the technologies and my suggestions on how to communicate with your surgeons, what questions to ask, what, let's say, to expect after the different setup of the IOLs, and etc. So honestly, you have a different options, and it's up to you what to choose.